Barbershop Barbershop episode podcast number 155. That works half almost. It is podcast 155. How are you doing tonight, Ryan Cannon?
Excellent.
Are you? You're all fired up and ready to go?
Yep.
You can't help it. We are coming to you live from Boxo Studio in Hamilton, Ontario, Canada. The blast furnace of original music, original musicians, original people, real stories, and great music. Every Wednesday, Barbershop Podcast streaming live on Twitch TV. And, of course, we have our channel on YouTube. Be sure to subscribe to what we're offering. And, well, that's it. We got Twitch. We got Stitcher Radio. Help me out here, Ryan Cannon.
That's all of them.
Yeah, that's right, because we figured out, is Google Plus still a thing or no?
No, we
it's no longer a thing.
Did an archaeological dig on our Google Plus page.
And we got like 12,000 hits on a page that we
haven't. Someone's looking.
That we haven't put anything up in like forever. So maybe it's not dead, or maybe, I don't know.
Gary,
do you know?
All right.
Gary doesn't know.
Sorry. Gary's on it.
For Ryan Cannon and Gary Greenland, want to welcome you to another great Wednesday of rock and roll music out of Hamilton. We got so many great people, so many great musicians here in Hamilton. It never seems to end, and tonight's guest is no different. He's been around. I don't want to say he's an old guy, but he's been doing this for a while, and he has been pleasing and teasing for a long time, playing rock and roll of all styles, from the singer-songwriter song nights, grinding it out Hootie style on the acoustic guitar, or like tonight when he's brought a big rock and roll band in here. You want to give a big Barbershop Podcast welcome to Dougy Flyswatter. How you doing, Doug? You brought the band in, the Dougy Flyswatter band.
It's a great feeling. It should, that's for sure.
I would think it's a great feeling because they've said that once you've gone on stage, you're ruined for everything else, right?
That's pretty much true, yeah.
At least damaged.
Yeah, it happened like when I was about 16. I started playing in bars, and it's been a couple years since then. And but yeah, I thoroughly enjoy it, or I wouldn't still be doing it, right?
Yeah. And was writing part of the deal early on, or did that come along later too?
No, that kind of happened, I guess, in my 20s. I guess it was just I was like, where do I go from here? Like, I was in cover bands a lot, and it was just like, well, I want
to. It's kind of the thing to do.
I want to start getting in original bands, right?
Yeah. So introduce who you brought in tonight. Tell me about the band, the Dougy Flyswatter band, and they were sound checking tonight, sounding good. Tight.
Oh, good stuff. Good stuff. This is Carm DiBraccio on the drums, and Carm's been with me for like 15 years, really.
Yeah, Carm. Oh, it must be either liking it, or it must be... it's been good. How are you doing?
Good. How are you?
Good. So have you been a drummer your whole life, or was it kind of like left to you that this is... You're good on... Because quite a few drummers come in here are good on a lot of different instruments. Other ones are just born and raised to play the drums. What are you?
Well, I started when I was around 13, and I learned how to play from listening to Rush albums.
Well, that's a good place to start.
Yeah.
So, and different styles, I mean, it kind of gets dropped in your lap. Do you hear different types of music, or do you hear just patterns? And it doesn't matter what you're playing.
Oh, it depends on what the song is. Every song has a different feel to it and requires something different from the drum kit. So,
wow, that
depends on the song.
That's so cool. And to introduce your guitar players, like, you know, it's always, you know, and as a bass player, quite often guys can come in here and just bring an acoustic guitar if they want to. But as a bass player, you had to bring in the meat tonight. So introduce the meat who you brought in
there.
It's
great having guitar players with me. This is a good friend of mine, Blair Jacobs.
How you doing, Blair? Good. You like for you as a guitar player? Were you early on like?
I was in a singer in high school in the band, and I played drums after that for a little bit, and then guitar.
And that was
17 or 18, I guess.
Yeah, it's a transportable instrument too, so it's kind of nice as you have those early years and you got to move around a lot.
Yeah,
have something you can carry, right?
Yeah.
So it stuck to you. It sounded great tonight. And who else you got?
Of course, John Ingalls here.
Of course, it is. Yeah. How you doing tonight, John?
I'm doing great, thanks. Yeah.
Can you believe we're all related?
No, I cannot. I cannot. So, well, what's your abbreviated rock and roll story?
My abbreviated rock story? I guess I had my first rock band when I was about 14 or 15. I started on the piano. I've worked through a bunch of instruments since then, and I still seem to be playing.
So cool. So cool. All right, and you've been working on a new record. You got some tunes that are cooking, that are fresh and hot.
Yeah. I've been recording out at Junction Studios with my good friend Darcy McGilligan.
Yep.
Awesome dude. He doesn't like to name drop, but he's worked with some really good people. Yeah. Rick Derringer, Johnny Winter, just name a few. But yeah, and things are going good out there. And now I'm going to be dragging these guys out there with me too to finish up some songs.
Hooting and hollering.
Yeah.
The whole darn way. Well, you come in here to play some live rock and roll music, and we're going to hear some of the new stuff you recorded, and we're going to do what we do best. We love music, and we record it. And again, I want to put my hands out and together for Ryan Cannon and Gary Greenland for every week. They make bands sound so good, come in here. And as you know, like technically it can be a real bitch to get everyone sounding good and pumping out through three wires.
Oh, yeah, man.
And have it come. But you guys are dialed in. What are you going to start off with tonight?
We're going to start off with a song from CD I Said Hey. It's called Cowboy.
All right, the song
and
is
I
called...
And I keep wanting to talk into that microphone.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, you can't wait to go. All right, so right, Cowboy, here right here, right now, barbershoppodcast.com.
Thank you.
Who wouldn't want to be a cowboy? After that, a rock and roll and rollicking number. Here, Dougy Flyswatter, the Dougy Flyswatter Band, coming into Barbershop Podcast. There is good original music. There is great live music. I like it when I saw Tyson's band, Rat Rod, as I was staying up at the Dog Pound, and it was such a good time sitting there drinking some cheap draft, listening to all of those cover songs, and the playing was so great, and all those guys, everyone was smoking, and it was fun. It was good to get out, and that's what I'm saying. If you're the casual observer, if you stumbled upon it, this all stems from live music. These people who come in every week, they play live, they play out and about, and you can find them. You can Google their names. You can look under live music. We suggest very strongly that you support your live music scene. It's important to keep it vibrant because that is art. And when we're talking about art, especially in Hamilton, we're not necessarily talking about people from driving really far away to go look at all the little art galleries. Talk about having a good time on the town. And music is a big part of that. No, that's good. It kind of worked. It was my ka-ching. So I'm going to ask the four of you. Why don't you relate to me one of your greatest live music experiences? And it can be one that happened early that kind of set the tone for you, or it can be one that happened recently but just it still blew your mind. So we'll go left to right, start with John.
Oh, wow. Now that's a tough one.
Yeah, hitting you hard because you've seen a few shows, I imagine, over
the years.
Yeah,
I'd like to duck before you throw that at me. I'd have to say that one jumped into my mind. And it was the Minute by Minute tour with the Doobie Brothers back in the 70s, and it was pretty amazing.
Probably the musicianship and the tightness. Oh, and the
vocals.
Yeah.
The production.
Production.
Yeah. It sticks with you, man.
Yeah. And it's not like a record because you knew the songs. You love the Doobies. That's why you bought a ticket to go see a show. So explaining to people about what live music is that recorded music isn't. Like, you get a taste of this. You get a little live music in your living room every Wednesday, but it ain't the same thing. So tell me about what, you know, because you've seen a few shows.
You can hug a recording, too, you know.
You can. That's true.
But it's not the same.
Yeah. There you go. For all you Pornhub fans. <That's>... All right, Dougy. What about your greatest live music experience story?
Greatest live music experience?
Or story, not that you were in.
I got a crazy story that happened to me live.
Not that you were playing, one that you were a fan.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, one where you were in the audience.
All right. The first real concert I got to go see was, it was going to be Foreigner and Loverboy.
I saw that in Buffalo, Ted Nugent.
And Billy Squire was supposed to be on the show, right?
Yeah.
On the bill, and I was like, oh, well, I don't know. Yeah, I guess I'll go. My uncle's asked me to go, and I go, I guess I'll go.
Yeah.
And Billy Squire canceled, and they put in Iron Maiden instead. And I was like, in heaven. It was the first band I've seen in a concert.
I looked at that bill, and I was a kid, and knew, what the hell? How did this happen? And we got in line to go to one of the stores and waited for 45 hours at Rich Stadium and you found out you couldn't buy beer until noon or something like that. And it was 8 in the morning. I don't know. But those were the days. That was a great. And we were within the same circle of people.
And that day, actually, Loverboy kicked ass.
They sure did.
They were unbelievable live band.
Way better than Foreigner.
Yeah.
That's true.
Yeah.
All right. Pass the duchy to the left hand side.
Live band thing that I went and saw. Speaking of, is Iron Maiden.
Yeah. That must have catered to your youthful aggression at the time.
Yeah, and it was at Maple Leaf Gardens. You know, I was 14, maybe 15.
Yeah. Just did it for you. Flipped a switch.
Oh yeah.
You have to remember Trooper too.
Yeah. You can't go back. You're having buyer's regret. It happens.
Yeah. There's more too, but
cool, of course. All right, and one that stuck with you, with live music, and it could be a big show, it could be a small show, it could be a long time ago, it could be recent.
Not any one show in particular, but any show with the Dougy Flyswatter Band over the years has been memorable. Because each show is different. There's always something different, something crazy going on. It's unfreakable.
Yeah. And it's that's all I'm gonna say is nothing, because I know it's true. All right, Barbershop Podcast. We have stories. We have rock and roll. We have a video. Letting a lot of guys come in here, but we do do that. Barbershop Podcast, you're a guest on the show. Make sure you got a video. Show it to us. You know what we're going to play.
The Dirty Blues.
Oh, Dirty Blues.
You know, bluesy on you now.
Got to love that.
Yeah.
Well, we do it. We do it all. We do it every week right here at barbershoppodcast.com. right. That's the Dirty Blues. We all know about the Dirty Blues, don't we, Mr. Dougy Flyswatter? Dougy Flyswatter in here with the Dougy Flyswatter Band. They are a rock and roll band. They got a show coming up this week at the fabled Corktown Tavern.
Next Friday. Friday the 13th.
It's a dangerous, scary night. Go to the Corktown. It's haunted. I guarantee you. You know, a good time there. They're here playing rock and roll. We're going to have another healthy slice of it. What do you got dialed up for us next?
We're going to do a live tune right now? Okay, yeah. We will do Lounge Lizard.
Lounge Lizard. You know, and I like that when you put some thought to the lyrics and the title of the song. It's got to paint a little picture. Got to make people, it's like an album cover. People got to want to know what's inside. So, you know, don't write your diary. Write something salacious. Some people are going to want to see. Some people are going to want to hear. We're hearing it right here, now at barbershoppodcast.com.
When you're caught up in the grind, well, you swear it's so sexy from the left to the right. You swear it's so sexy. We got a party all night. Guess you better call your roommate.
That brand of rock and roll comes to you courtesy Dougy Flyswatter. Got a new record coming out. Any Yeah, you don't want to hex him with a guesstimate of the release date. We know about that. And it's like, remember, what was it, Ron Elliott the first time when Ryan and I were putting the 420 conspiracy together? It's a great Captain Easy record. And we had to release it on 420. You know, what's the point if you're going to do something called the 420 conspiracy? And so we set, you know, we had to have a record by a certain date. And he's like, you never make your CD party before you have a CD in your hand. So sometimes things are worth waiting. Good things are worth waiting a little bit for.
And trying to put up stuff digitally now, you never know when it's actually going to actually show up online.
Yeah, that's true. They take their time. There's a lot out there. But searching and seeking and doing stuff like you can do on the interweb right here with Barbershop Podcast, someone you may never have stumbled upon, all of a sudden magically, boom, they're your new favorite thing. And you can be a center of influence and share that stuff with other people. Share this show. Share the people you see on this show. Say, oh, yeah, I don't know about that, you know, stuff on the radio. What's a radio anyway? We're too old to know what a radio is. Ryan Cannon, Gary Greenland, I am going to spin an ad for our greatest sponsor over at hamiltonartists.ca. They have been with us for over a year now. They have just won the Hamilton Spectator Reader's Choice Award for Best Print Shop and Promotional Shop. So if you want to print something on something, if you want to promote something, you go to hamiltonartists.ca. They're 1141 Main Street East at Balmoral in Hamilton. That's just east of the Delta. And they print anything on anything. You can go and visit them online, as I said, at hamiltonartists.ca, or go to their actual store. A lot of great displays, a lot of custom wear. If you're a rock and roller and you wanted to get a nudie suit or something crazy, or if, exactly. Dougy Flyswatters, Flyswatters. Okay. Yeah. And they're the kind of people who will work with you on that creative bent. You know, you got to have that. And they do the vinyl wrap now, so you could like wrap the whole your whole car in a Dougy Flyswatter theme, right?
It's the vinyl wrap. That's kind of cool, right?
You got to like it. You got to love it. HamiltonArtists.ca. barbershoppodcast.com. All right, music and the love of music is what we're about. We kind of pick your brains throughout the show about things you love about music, and just pop into mind, is there your current like listening? I'm always curious if people, especially once they start writing their own stuff, if they listen to anything at all, or they only listen to their own music at that point. Is there anyone that is still like a go-to for you, like out of your record collection, out of your playlist, that you just can't get enough of, or is kind of proven to be stands the test of time over the years? Now's your chance to say Trooper, John.
I got roots deep in with Madonna's first album. No,
you were on that, weren't you?
Not at all.
The old metal still, you like that?
Well, yeah, I'll still listen to Iron Maiden once in a while. Yeah. Like, new stuff, you know, like, it's neat that they got three guitar players now. They didn't boot anybody out for filling in for somebody, you know what I mean? That's kind of neat.
They all lost 30%.
Because I've had that happen to me where I was booted from bands. So.
It's always
filling
so
in for someone, and then you got to eventually leave. It's true.
How about the rest of you, John? Like, who's your go-to on your playlist, or and someone of our generation out of your record collection?
It's just become an exploration of the great universe.
Yeah,
we almost never look
too,
at the same thing twice. It's become insane and disjointed. There is so much music in the world that, you know, there's really, you don't have to go over the same ground.
No, it's
so
true.
When you do,
is there anyone? I'm curious.
I don't know. I guess it's the pursuit of live music for me.
Yeah. It's really a big difference. And then you, so do you have someone that you like put on when you need to chill out, or someone when you need to get excited?
Something to inspire me from that I've been listening to my whole life since I discovered them is Thin Lizzy. Anybody who listens or anybody who is involved in Thin Lizzy.
You could, you can do a cover band. You should be in a Thin Lizzy cover band. Yeah, I think it's like, and that is real rock and roll, and it's real Irish too. So I like that. How about you, brother?
Whenever I need a good source of musical inspiration, I just go back and listen to pretty much anything from the old Steely Dan catalog because they had so many different great players on those albums, and they used some of my favorite drummers on those recordings as well. So that's it for me right there.
Yeah, good call. Because whenever I hear a Steely Dan tune on the radio, it just, it's like, it even though I knew where I was when that came out, it doesn't sound dated. It doesn't sound cliche. It's like nobody did that shit before and nobody did that shit after. Like, they did that shit, and I guess that's what I like, you know. Individuality, real rock and roll music. We got that here at Barbershop Podcast. Oh, Gary Greenland is helping out tonight. And I don't even say he's helping out. He's helping us out from going insane because he does what he does so great. We're going to start a fundraising campaign for Gary Greenland's microphone. It will be up next week, and we will give it 30 days. Whatever money we raise in 30 days is the money we will spend on Gary's microphone. If we raise $12, that's what we're going to spend on Gary's microphone.
Then he gets Fisher Price.
I'm hoping he gets a Neumann, you know. I'm hoping it goes viral, and we get him a $23,000 microphone that we're allowed to use.
Oh, it's still our mic, regardless. It's still our mic. He doesn't get to keep it. He gets to use it for an hour a week.
All right. We're going to do another. We're going to do the first one off of the CD. And this is going to be the new CD, Sunglasses in the Rain.
Oh, Sunglasses in the Rain is the first song I've done out of Darcy's studio, the Junction.
Yeah.
I don't know if it's going to be the first song on the CD. There's going to be probably 7 songs on it, so I just got 2 finished up right now, and 14 others in the works, so just pick and choose. But
with a name like that, it's destined for greatness, I tell you.
Sunglasses in the Rain, it's kind of like, it's just like the story of my attitude, really. It's
there you go.
You just gotta grin and bear it.
Grin and bear it. Barbershoppodcast.com.
Thank you.
yeah. That'd be Dougy Flyswatter up there at our friend Darcy recording some wicked shit at Junction. It is going to be available on the interweb and in your greasy little hands should you choose to come out and see a live rock and roll show, because I'm sure you'll be selling out of there.
It is up on iTunes, actually.
It's on iTunes already. Usually they're the iTunes. Sluggish. Look,
that's what I mean. You never know when they're going to come out. That's like...
Way to go, iTunes. Good job. All right. Good music available everywhere, but especially here, Live Wednesday, for those of us, we have to be here, but you don't. And if you're tuning in of your own volition, God love you. And here's a treat. Some live music from Dougy's Flyswatter right here, right now at BabbittShopPodcast.com.
Reaching for our dreams in the open sky. I was searching for something to say. I said, hey, then you looked, then you smiled, then you winked your eye. I got caught up in a certain style. You were a certain style in that day.
Like Joseph Stalin style, just fancy enough to get the job done. I gotta love it. Dougy Flyswatter and the Dougy Flyswatter band in here at Barbershop Podcast, rocking and rolling the way we used to do it in the old days. Big smile on your face and not worrying too much about the rest of it. Kind of takes care of itself. No, when you get in the flow and everyone's playing and everyone's having it's magical. You know, it's like there's a few times when I was pretty wasted. And I just smiled because I was not in control anymore. And then you look at your hands and you almost try to fuck up and you couldn't, you know, because you've planed. You're in a different place, right? And I know each and one of you have been there, right? You've elevated at some point in time on stage where you're like, this is pretty amazing, right? It's like a drug, isn't it?
Well, right here, right now, this is pretty fun too, right?
It's like this is your fix every Wednesday, Barbershop Podcast. We do our best to do it right. We bring it to you. It is definitely a do-it-yourself thing, but we started.
We get a little sweat going here.
You do, yeah.
He's
we
getting a sweat going.
We work. We work you hard down here. If you don't leave a mark, someone wasn't doing the job. That's what we like to say. Well, do we like to say that, Ryan? Can we say that now?
What are we saying?
Sign me up.
I wasn't ready.
I know.
I was totally not paying attention. What are we doing? Do you need the boom voice?
Yeah, sure. Why not? I'm going to introduce the new CD song from Dougy Flyswatter. All right. That's enough of that.
All right.
It's called The Burn, and we've all been burned. We've all felt the burn. There's the good burn, like working out at the gym. And then there's the bad burn, like getting burned.
This is more about the bad burn.
The bad burn, yeah. And it's funny because you do get a little bit of a thick skin on your ass after getting the burn. And sometimes it's for the greater good, like you get a song out of it, right?
Well, yeah, I hope so anyway.
Like, well, we're going to listen to it off your record. This is another...
But it's a totally different feel for me, this one, and I don't know, I'm pretty proud of it, yeah.
All right, we're going to hear it right here, right now, barbershoppodcast.com.
Remember in the dark, I feel the burn.
providing a near fatal mix of both live and recorded music is what we do every week at Barbershop Podcast. True. Well, actually, truth be spoken, you can't get enough of it. And we're going to give you more of it, more live music right here, right now.
Yes, we are. This is called Smile to Suit My Style.
Smile to Suit My Style. I like it. Once
yet
again.
To be released, but
yeah, it was
soon
sweet.
Come, you know.
Suit soon come, come, and you know? Get to hear it first. Right here, barbershoppodcast.com.
What's been happening? I saw the sparkles in the air. So nearly tragic when you couldn't come. I guess it's too much drama there. I can just imagine what is going on. Are you pulling out your hair? Are we missing daring destiny? Are we destined if we dare? What you wanna be? Well, can you open up your mind? Are you worried about what you want from me? Feeling for dollars you cannot find. Whoa, baby, listen to your lessons learned. Read through the riddle in my rhyme. Well, then, baby.
Dougy Flyswatter right here at barbershoppodcast.com. We are rocking and rolling, and it's not going to stop. It's not going to stop right now because we're going to go right to a video. We are wild and furious pace here at Barbershop Podcast.
I think Halloween just passed us, but
you thought you saw
still
a ghost.
Couple ghosts hanging around. Yeah.
Here it is. I think I've seen a ghost right here.
Oh, a ghost.
Barbershoppodcast.com. Truly spooky right here. Barbershop Podcast. Don't ever be afraid of what's out there. It ain't that scary, unless you want it to be. Sometimes we want it to be, though, right?
This is freaky funky.
Freaky funky. Come on. I'm trying to do a little bit of buzz, a little bit of spin. Right. We're catching the buzz right here with Dougy Flyswatter. He's going to spin one more live one for us. You want to tell the story or you just want to let her rip?
Okay. I played this song in Toronto one day. We were doing a benefit. It was a sick kids benefit. I was playing with Maria Del Mar from National Velvet. She booked the whole thing, and she put Rush on the bill. Rush didn't make it that night. We opened up. We played this song instead. This was instead of Rush. We did Floppy Doll Alarm.
There we go. Floppy Doll Alarm. You don't like it, and then screw you right here. Barbershoppodcast.com.
Set the stage. So I set the stage. Well, I guess it's time to set the stage. So I set the stage. So you got me a trench, do the floppy doll dance. So you got me a trench, do the floppy doll dance. Floppy doll. Set it straight. So I set it straight. Well, I guess it's kind of set it straight. So I set it straight. So you got me a trench, do the floppy doll dance. So you got me a trench, do the floppy doll dance. Floppy doll. Why do we carry on this way? Go! Go! Floppy doll alarm! Floppy doll alarm! Floppy! Ow!
Lovely. Just want to let you know before we say goodbye tonight, we had from our chat room at Twitch TV, Ingalls. So thank you for correcting your own grammar in the ghost song. It may have prevented nightmares.
It annoys
from
a lot
video.
Of people. Hey, like, why listen to the ghost? Oh, yeah. All right.
Well, we had a great time. Thanks, guys, for coming out tonight. I hope you had a good time.
Hey, awesome, it was great. Thanks for having us here.
Our pleasure. Awesome.
It's a good time. All thanks, right, guys, for Gary Greenland and Ryan Cannon, I am your host, Kevin Barber. We're here every week, and we'll be next week. We'll be here with our very good friends in Sloppy Jalopy. They are kicking ass, right, and God, I love them.
Maybe.
Love them. Next week.
Maybe Al will give a repeat performance from last time.
Let's hope. Toot, toot. See you next week. Barbershop Podcast.com.